Next up, we have Jay Hawk, escorted by his parents, Paul and Shannon Hawk. Jay's also been a member of the basketball program for 4 years. He's also a member of our football team and also enjoys working out. Next year, he plans to major in finance and also play football at the collegiate level. Congratulations, Jay. Next up, we have Mikey Riddle with his parents, Mike and Billy Riddle. Mike has played basketball for 4 years and was also on our football team. Next year, his plans are to attend lineman school down in Georgia. Congratulations, Mikey. Next up is Sal Tabone with his parents, Mike and Cheryl Tabone. Sal's been in our program for 4 years. He's also a three-sport athlete, playing soccer, football, and track, four-sport athlete with basketball. Next year, he'll be looking to attend aviation school. Congratulations, Sal. Last but not least, D. Keegan Whitfield, escorted by his parents, Miranda Pressler and Nick Whitfield Sr. Keegan's been a member of our program for 4 years. He's also a member of our football and track teams. Next year he's undecided, but he's possibly will be attending SUNY Morrisville and also playing football. Congratulations to all of our seniors. Coach Petrano would like to thank all the parents, students, for all of your support for all of our home games this year. Please continue supporting them as we enter into the playoffs in a couple weeks. Thank you.
Yeah, we're good. A huge night of high school basketball here in the Fredonia High School Gymnasium as the 13-5 Hillbillies welcome the 14-3 Allegheny Limestone Gators. Good evening, everyone. I am Kevin Syracuse alongside Drew Yelich here as this is our first broadcast together. Drew, pleasure to have you on here.
I'm excited for some high-powered basketball here tonight. You know, like you said, we've got 14-3 against 13-14. Last matchup was a Fredonia victory in overtime, 74-71. I would expect something similar here tonight in Fredonia. We've got some good basketball ahead of us, I'd say.
Yeah, so Fredonia's coming into this game red hot. They started the season 5-4, but since they have won 8 out of their last 9. And like you said, mixed in there was that 74-71 overtime victory over these Allegheny Limestone Gators. And that was just a great game. Obviously, we weren't there for that. That was a few miles away. But, you know, great win for the Hillbillies because prior to that, they beat Southwestern and they had beat the Duncan Marauders, but they had a 3-game losing streak before that. So that was a huge win that kind of propelled them into this long winning streak here.
Yeah, and to counter that, we have Allegheny Limestone, who since that game was played 3 weeks ago, has won 5 out of 6 of their games, only seeing one of those losses there to Salamanca, a 2-point loss at Salamanca just a few days ago, maybe a week. You've got Allegheny Limestone averaging almost 60 points a game, to counter that with only 46.5. That's a low number to give up a game for Allegheny Limestone, and with Fredonia averaging close to 65 points a game, that's going to be a pretty good matchup to see whose defense and offense can counter each other the best.
Yeah, the Gators always have a tough defense. That's one of the staples of an Allegheny Limestone team. But like you said, Fredonia is averaging a few more points than the Gators are giving up, so maybe those numbers will balance out tonight. I mean, they did in that first matchup as it just came right down to the wire. So I think we're going to be in store for a great night of high school basketball here.
Absolutely. You know, we've got almost 150 points scored between the two of them in that matchup 3 weeks ago. High scoring affair, especially considering it's high school basketball. Maybe we'll see something like that here tonight. Can't count on it, but you know, we're looking forward to it for sure.
Well, you mentioned some of the stats here and the amount of points that have been scored by these teams. So let's take a look at the stats as we're about 3 minutes away from the buzzer going off, and then we'll get into the starting lineups and the national anthem. So starting with the home team, the Fredonia Hillbillies, they are led by 4 key players. There's really no one go-to guy, and this team is just so great at sharing the wealth.
Yeah, and that's going to be an important part of this play here. You know, we're looking at the, thank you for the points per games here. You've got guys who are averaging over 10 points a game, all 4 of them, Hahn, Fry, White, and Hawk. Averaging close to 11, 13, 14, and 12 points. You know, it's well distributed. And on the other hand, with Allegheny Limestone, you've got guys where there seems to be one guy who is going to be the go-to guy that I think Fredonia is going to have their eye on. Anthony DeCapua has got 17.5 points a game. A couple other guys, Carson Kwiatkowski has 10.5 a game. And you've got a nice little settle in 4 or 5 guys that are averaging close to 10. Right around that 7 points a game. So they're distributing the ball, but it seems like they have one go-to guy here with Anthony DeCapua, and Fredonia is a more well-balanced, rounded-out team, it seems.
Yeah, and, you know, I mentioned how the Hillbillies don't have that one go-to scorer, but that's the beauty of it, is they can have a go-to scorer if they need to. Like the other night, Davion White stepped up and chipped in with the double-double. He had 22 points and 10 rebounds. I was on the call with WDOE for that game, and we gave him player of the game because whenever Fredonia needed a big bucket, it was Davion White. And then, you know, we've seen Ethan Fry come up big with multiple games this year. He had a stretch last week where he had 2 triple-doubles in 7 days. So he's been playing great all-around basketball. And then obviously there's Jay Hawk too, who's averaging just under 11 points and just under 9 rebounds per game. So like we said, those 4, no one's really taking the lead in terms of scoring like we see with Anthony DeCapua here, but the beauty of that is anyone can step up when their name's called upon.
Right, and I think that's what the dynamic aspect of basketball in general is you can have a team that's really well-balanced, but every once in a while you can see a guy who just jumps out and has an excellent game and carries the team on his back. And, you know, with DeCapua on Allegany-Limestone, you know, maybe he's the guy tonight, but it looks like he's got a well-rounded set of characters behind him, too, that maybe can help step up. So let's kick this over. We're going to go over to National Anthem, I think, here.
Yeah, we'll take the National Anthem, get the starting lineups, and we'll be back for opening tip-off.
Sung tonight by Miriam Labar, Ava Hartung, and Leah Marsh.
All right, here we go as the starting lineups were announced. So we'll take a look at the opening starters here. First for the visiting Gators.
So we've got number two, Gabe Ramadan. He's going to be starting with number five, Anthony DeCapua. Number 13, Carson Kwiatkowski. Number 20, Michael Frederick. Number 21, Gavin Truman. For Fredonia, we're going to be going with number three, Keegan Whitfield. And we're going to go with 32, Jay Hawk. Number five is
Ethan Fry.
Number 22, South Bone. And number 33.
Okay. Got a little thrown off here. Absolutely. Nick Petrando and the Hillbillies are going with an all-senior starting lineup. Right. So we had to make some quick shuffles to our starting lineups here.
That's nice to pay tribute to the seniors, get them out here for their last game or last season with Fredonia basketball.
So here we go, opening tip-off between Jayhawk and Anthony DeCapua is won by the Hillbillies. And here they go with Sal Tabone, giving it to Ethan Fry in the corner as we are underway. Fry backs out on his defender, puts up the shot, no good. Rebounded by DeCapua. Gators working it around here in the opening few seconds of this game. Got a big crowd here tonight. Friday night, senior night, as ball gets worked around into the paint, and the shot is good by number 21, Gavin Truman. Gators play a little bit of a full court press here.
That was some good ball movement by Allegany Limestone there, finding an open guy.
And we're going to have a turnover here as Sal Tabone, a little bit of miscommunication there with his teammates. Gators get the ball back. Ramadan will bring it up and give it to DeCapua, the leading scorer for the Gators. Gators working around the perimeter once again. This is number 20, Michael Frederick, into the paint to Truman again. Now back out. And we're going to have a foul.
That's a three-point shot.
That was number 13, Carson Kwiatkowski, who got fouled by number 5, Ethan Fry.
Petrando's got a couple words for the referee. I'm not sure he liked that call.
So Kwiatkowski will be at the line shooting three.
Good ball movement early by Allegany-Limestone. Finding open guys, getting that open three-point shot, creating that foul.
Yeah, that's another characteristic of a Gators team here. Strong defense, like we already mentioned, and great passing. First free throw was good. Second one rolls in.
Rattled in.
And the third, no good. Rebounded by Ethan Fry. He looks to push, drives in, one on two, stops, kicks it back out. Jayhawk, pump fake, back to Fry. Jump stop, out to Riddle. Thought about that shot, now gives it to fellow senior Keegan Whitfield. Now Fry will try the three, and it's good. Ethan Fry gets the Hillbillies on the scoreboard, 4-3.
Nice pass by Keegan Whitfield there to find him outside the three-point mark.
Ramadan over to Frederick. Now a handoff here. This is DeCapo, a tough shot, and he gets it to fall.
Nice drive.
Tabone hands it to Hawk here. Looks to set up the offense. Ethan Fry will try another three. It's good. Fry's starting to cook early.
6 points. All six for Fredonia so far.
Ramadan drives in on Sal Tabone, puts up a tough shot, no good. Rebound by Tabone.
That's up a good Fry. Rebound by that Tabone there.
Fry
not the tallest
in,
guy.
Spins. Hibbley's worked the ball back out. Keegan Whitfield to Riddle. Shot is no good there. Now the Gators push. Ramadan slows things down. Into the corner now. Down low to Truman. Kicks it back out. Kwiatkowski. And he buries that one.
That's a nice shot.
9-6 here. In Fredonia. Ethan Fry pushes the other way. Gives it to Riddle. And we're going to have a foul on the floor.
Both teams early are looking to set up their own offense when they get the ball possession. That's the first fast break we've really seen where they've taken it to the hoop there. Drawing a foul over the top.
And now we're going to have some of the normal starters coming back in. So it'll be Mike Hahn, number 0, and Davion White, number 23. Whitfield gets the inbound pass. Works it over to Fry. Now out to White. Back to Fry. He'll try another three. Short. Rebounded by the Gators.
Good looking attempt there. Just couldn't get that one to fall.
DeCapua drives in. Another tough shot. No good. Rebounded by, well, it looked like it was Whitfield, but
I think he's going to give it to White there.
Yeah,
or is that Jayhawk?
Yeah. So credit Jayhawk with the rebound there. Hibbley's working their offense. Down low to Hawk now. Puts up the shot. Can't get it to fall.
Little strong, but that's some pretty good body movement.
Rebounded by DeCapua, the 6'2 senior guard. Like we mentioned, the leading scorer for the Gators this year. Gators working around once again. Ramadan, another senior guard for Allegany. Kwiatkowski, he's just a sophomore. Truman, another senior. 7 on the shot clock as Kwiatkowski puts up a shot. No good. Rebounded by Hawk. Fredonia will slow things down.
It was a good possession by Allegany Limestone. It comes up empty, but they had some good ball movement there. Fredonia looks to set up their offense.
Fry drives in. Jump stop. Count it. And one. Another strong take for Ethan Fry, who now has 8 points, all 8 points, actually, for the Hillbillies.
Yeah, he's off to a good start here. 2 3-pointers, a nice strong drive, getting that one to fall for the end one.
Prior to that foul, I mean, it's been a pretty clean game here. Yep. Clock's been moving, 3:54 left in the opening quarter. We're gonna have a sub now for the Gators. But that was just the second foul for Allegany, and Fredonia just with one. So like I said, pretty clean game here so far for two of the top teams in the area.
Yeah, it's a good flow so far.
And the free throw was good.
To fall.
9-9 here. Under 4 minutes to go in the opening quarter. Gators working back out. Ramadan sets things up.
Very content with getting it into their own offense here. Not trying to push anything. Not looking for any quick, fast breaks.
The Gators are very calm, cool, and collected. Now Ramadan gets it with 10 on the shot clock. Drives in and puts up the shot. No good. Rebounded by Jay Hawk.
That's 3 rebounds for Hawk. He's all over the ball underneath the rim.
Like I mentioned, he averages about 9 a game, so it's already a third of the way there.
He's clearly the biggest guy on the floor. He's going to have to maintain that physical presence.
Keegan Whitfield drives in, excuse me. Fry out to White. Stops and gives it to Whitfield, who drives in. Back to White. That one is stripped.
A quick steal.
DiCapua comes in all alone, and he finishes. Defense turned to offense right there for the Gators. 11-9.
Quick turnover turns into 2 points and a 2-point lead for Allegany-Limestone.
Now Whitfield will try to run the offense. Stops and gives it back out to Fry. He'll jack up a three.
He's feeling it. That's 4 opportunities. He's throwing it up. It's 2 for 4.
Ramadan back the other way. Nice pass, and the banks are open for Michael Frederick. Make that 13-9. Gators with a full court press. Whitfield drives in, and we're going to have a foul on the floor here. I believe that'll go to number 33, Andrew Giardini. Ashton Putney will check in for Whitfield.
Imagine Fredonia's going to look to set that offense up again like they did early when they had some success throwing up some 3-pointers. Move the ball around, quick passes, find that open guy, and get a good shot opportunity here.
Well, I noticed that Keegan Whitfield was running the offense for the last couple of possessions, and they've been going through some different point guards this year, but it's really been clicking with Ethan Fry, so I would assume that he's going to be running the show for the time being. We're going to have a big block right there from DiCapua.
Well, he was all over that.
Exactly 2 minutes remaining here. Another sub now for Allegany. It'll be Sean Conroy. 5'10 junior guard. Fredonia gets it in here. Work it back to the corner with Ethan Fry. And he gets fouled, another and one. Like you said, Ethan Fry is feeling it early.
The offense is clearly running through him right now. He's got all the points on the board for Fredonia, and he's enjoying an early success for the senior night.
So 11 points for the Hillbillies, and all 11 coming off of the hand of Ethan Fry.
He looks to make it 12 here with this free throw. And he'll get it.
We're going to have another sub here. It'll be Ramadan coming back in. You know, last night I called the Dunkirk-Olean game in Dunkirk. Olean won that one 82-40.
Wow.
Jack DeRose had 41 points for the Huskies.
Oh, wow.
So he single-handedly outscored the Marauders.
That's an impressive feat.
So Ethan Fry is on track to do that right now.
On pace for 48.
Yeah. Ramadan running the point now. Gives it to Kwiatkowski in the corner. Back out to Ramadan. Gators work it back around. 12 on the shot clock. Good defense here for Fredonia. Floater is good.
It'll fall for him.
Ramadan gets it to fall. Ethan Fry back the other way, and he's going to get fouled on the floor.
Allegany-Limestone really possessing that ball. They're dragging that shot clock all the way down inside 10 seconds every time they maintain possession in the offensive side of the court.
Yeah, we talked about Allegany for being a great defensive team, and Fredonia's right up there with them. That's a characteristic of a hillbilly team. Strong defenses. Ashton Putney gets the inbound here. Now this is Mike Hahn, one of the leading scorers for the Hillbillies. Gives it to Fry, tough shot. Doesn't get it to drop that time, but he's going back to the line.
He will draw the foul there. You know, and we talked about how many points per game that Allegheny-Limestone is giving up. Pretty low number at just 46 and a half. Looking at the way that they possess the ball on the offensive side of the court, you'd have to think that might play a big factor in it. You know, possessing that underneath 10 seconds, you're running a lot of clock off of each time you possess the ball.
Yeah, that's a good point.
Limiting the opportunities and possessions for the other team can absolutely help.
Fry makes the first one, so make that 13 now for Fredonia and for Ethan Fry. 14. 14 to 15 is the score. Just over 1 minute remaining in this opening quarter. Gators waiting for the call from their coach. They're coached by Glenn Anderson. Don't think we mentioned that yet. Nice backdoor cut. And we're going to have a foul here on Mike Hahn. That'll be Anthony DiCapua going to the line. Talked about DiCapua as the leading scorer for the Gators. Comes into tonight's game averaging 17.5 points, 5.6 rebounds, and exactly 2 assists, while having 24 steals and 10 blocks on the season.
He's an active player. We've seen a lot of him already. As he gets that first one to fall, that'll put him at 5 points. All over the place, we saw him make that steal at the other end, turn that into 2 points on a quick fast break. He made that block in the corner on a three-point opportunity by White. He's making his presence known early as he gets the other one to fall there.
Make that 17 to 14. 45 seconds left in the quarter. Ashton Putney will try a three. There we go. There are the first points scored by someone other than Ethan Fry.
So wide open in the corner there.
Yeah, 17 all here. Game shot and shot clock are separated by just 1 second. DiCapua now. Based on how the Gators have played this quarter, I would think that they'd want to wind this down as far as they can.
Absolutely. They're going to take this down, try to get the last shot of the quarter.
Maybe
that's
not
what I would have thought. However, as we speak,
Carson Kwiatkowski buries that one. Now Ethan Fry comes back with 5 seconds out to Davion White. No
nice
good.
Nice opportunity there just off the rim.
And that'll do
full
it for
court shot, no good.
The opening quarter as the Allegheny Limestone Gators take a 20-17 lead into the second quarter. Well, Drew, that was a pretty good quarter for both teams.
Yeah, we saw a little bit of offensive possessions setting it up, running out the clock by Allegheny Limestone. Fredonia is working their offense around. It ran mostly through Fry as he gets 14 of the 17 points in that first quarter for the senior. It's got to be pretty jacked up for senior night here. A couple of opportunities on the steals from Allegheny Limestone turned into some fast break points. Three-pointers, nobody shy about chucking them up right now. And so far, it's been a pretty high-scoring game, 20-17 after the first quarter. Looks like we're in store again for another high-scoring affair between the two.
And you mentioned how Ethan Fry has 14 points so far. His season average, he's averaging 14.4.
He's already hit his number.
He's already right there. And then add in a couple of rebounds for him as well. And, you know, he's putting it all together so far as we've seen him do as of late. Talked about Davion White on Monday against Southwestern. Fry had a nice game himself. 21 points, 6 rebounds, 6 assists. We mentioned the triple doubles as he's been doing his best impression of Russell Westbrook lately. Are you an NBA fan, by the way?
I only watch a little bit.
I was going to ask what you thought about
college
all
more
trades.
Yeah. No, I saw the trade for Kevin Durant go down. That's going to stack up the Phoenix Suns.
Woj bomb coming in late at night.
Crazy.
So KD is in Phoenix. Westbrook is in Utah. A lot of craziness in the NBA.
A lot of moving pieces.
So the Gators get it to start the second quarter here. This is DiCapua, goes behind the back. Nice move there. Now Kwiatkowski in the corner. Fredonia playing a 2-3 zone. And another deep three for the Gators. That one is off the mark, rebounded by Jay Hawk.
Another rebound by Hawk. He's all over it. The 2-3 zone is what Fredonia looks like they've been playing since the start.
Fry
limiting those
in.
Opportunities.
Strong take. Can't get that one to drop. Another nice behind-the-back move for DiCapua. Kwiatkowski back to DeCapua. Now Ramadan gets a call from his coach. Fredonia back to a man-to-man defense. Cross-court pass. Gators working back around. Ramadan looks to drive in. Kicks it back out. Giardini for a three. A little too strong there. Offensive rebound by number 21, Gavin Truman. Back to DeCapua, and he buries it. 23-17. Fry now running the offense. Jayhawk looks to set a screen. Now Putney will try another three. A little too strong there. Davion White, offensive rebound, goes back in. Strong take, and he finishes. And Fredonia will call a 30-second timeout. We'll keep it with you right here.
That's a good rebound and drive from Davion White there to get the bucket. Alert for the rebound coming off the back of the rim from the three-point shot from Putney. That one looked like it had a chance to go in. He's already got one three-pointer on the night.
Davion White is averaging 13.8 points per game and 6.1 rebounds per game and just over two assists, just under two steals, and about a half a block. So White is one of those guys who could get it done on both ends of the floor.
Right. Right, and he just did so down underneath the basket there, collecting that rebound. Hawk on the defensive end for Fredonia has been gathering up all the rebounds.
I didn't see the official number. I had him with, I believe, four or five rebounds the other night against Southwestern. So
he's already got four tonight.
Yeah, so a little quiet on that front the other night, but like you said, he's picking it up here tonight so far. So the Gators get it out of the timeout. Here's DeCapo, he drives in. Quick first move. Shot was no good, rebounded by Fry. Now up to White.
Looked like a quick transition there. As the referee's gonna call a travel.
Yeah, Jayhawk getting called for too many steps there.
Fredonia looked like they wanted to get their offense set up there. Faking that quick drive.
Now Ramadan. Down low to Giardini. Now to Kwiatkowski.
Just off the back.
Back of the iron. Rebounded by White. Under 6 minutes to go here in the first half. Mike Hahn, who's been relatively quiet so far, gives it to Fry. Now back out. This is Putney.
Looking for some space.
15 on the shot clock. Good defense here from the Gators. White drives in now. Back out, corner three. That was Putney. And we're gonna have an offensive foul. Yeah, I think they're gonna get Ethan Fry on that.
Yeah, pushing the back.
Now Fry will come out for Sal Tabone. One of the seniors on this Fredonia team.
It was a good possession by Fredonia. They kept moving it around. A strong defense though. By Allegany-Limestone, not letting anybody get free. Contested shots only. Drawing a foul ultimately on a rebound.
Ramadan to Truman for three, and he rattles that one in. Gators starting to pick it up here, 26-19, 5 minutes to go.
Ramadan adding to his assists on the night. Nice pass to find an open guy.
Entry-level pass down low to White, and he finishes. Fredonia needed that there. You could sense the momentum is starting to change in favor of the Gators. So good looking play right there from Hawk to White.
All Lime is really pressing on defense. They're forcing Fredonia to make some plays that maybe they're not comfortable with.
Sal Tabone with the steal. He comes in one on two. Now kicks it back out. Hahn over to Putney. That one gets stripped, but White is there. Now Tabone, he'll try a corner three.
A little strong on that one.
Yeah. Ramadan comes in one-on-one with White. And we're going to have an offensive foul. We're going to say that Ramadan pushed off.
Yeah. Referee all over that one.
I thought they were going to get White for the foul, but gave it to Ramadan with the offensive
push. Looks like he did just enough
push
to get it.
So with Ethan Fry on the bench, Sal Tabone will run the point. hands it off to Hahn. Now Putney, and we're going to have an offensive foul.
Blocking foul there.
That one will go on.
Got to set the feet. Fredonia has a lot of moving pieces when they set up their offense. A lot of the guys stay moving, and that can create that offensive foul there if you don't get set to try to set a pick.
Halfway through the second quarter here, Gators with a 5-point lead as they work the ball around here once more. This is Conroy, out to Truman. Cross-court pass, back to Truman. Looks to drive in, but good defense there from White. Back to the left corner here with DiCapo, and no good, another offensive rebound. DiCapo gets it back, puts up the shot, no good. Another offensive rebound.
Count it, and one. Giordani.
And it'll be Andrew Giardini, another senior playing here tonight. Take a look at his stats now. Averaging 7.3 points per game. He has 31 total rebounds on the year and 14 assists. And this is a name that I remember over the last few years. He's just always been a solid role player for this Gator team. And he's got some nice size to him as well.
And he used that to his advantage there. He was being guarded by Jay Hawk down low. Both guys are big, two of the biggest guys on the floor. And it looked like Hawk just mistimed it going up for that rebound, which gave the opportunity to Giardini to grab it and then put one up for a quick foul too. Missing that free throw though.
Yeah, I would say free throw is no good. Hibberley's get it back here down 7. They're working around. Here's to Bone, to Hawk. He'll try a 3, something we don't see often, but you wouldn't know based on that shot.
Looks nice natural to him.
Yeah, nice looking shot there for Jay Hawk. Brings it back to a 4-point game. DiCapua, Kwiatkowski, Conroy. Everyone touching the ball here so far. All 5 have touched the ball. This is Giardini now. Out to Kwiatkowski, and he buries that one. Nothing but net.
That's a good looking shot. As he puts his numbers up to 11 points on the night.
Real nice ball movement there for Allegheny. All 5 guys touched the ball.
And what we're seeing here, and we can talk about a little more at halftime, these guys are setting up, and they're not moving a whole lot. They get into their positions. They stay open with the zone that's being played, that Fredonia's got going on, and they just move the ball.
Another 3-point shot. That one is no good, rebounded by Hawk. Now to Bone. With a little over 2 minutes remaining here. Jim got pretty quiet here.
It was loud to start, that's for sure.
Yeah.
But
gonna need a
7-point game
here. DeBone picks up his dribble. Cross-court pass to White. He'll try a 3. Too strong. Rebounded by DiCapua. He looks to push. Under 2 to go. Back out to Conroy. Gators working around once again. Nice backdoor cut. And DiCapua can't finish.
Get it to go.
Real nice look there. That was a break that Fredonia needed. DeBone. Now this is White. Now Fredonia works it around the perimeter. Down low to White.
Wasting no time to set up their offense.
And he landed on Giardini. No foul was called.
Interesting play.
Yeah. And Conroy comes back the other way and he finishes. A little over a minute remaining here in this half. Fredonia down by 9.
An unfortunate turn of events for Fredonia there as Davion White fell on top of a fallen Allegany-Limestone player when he's going up for that rebound, which created a turnover and a quick break for Allegany-Limestone, 2 points.
Putney's 3 is no good. Offensive rebound by Mike Hahn, but they're going to say that he stepped on the baseline.
Good hustle play there to get that ball, just a little too much stepping on the line.
Now this is interesting. Ethan Fry was getting set to check in, but Fredonia pulled him back, and now Keegan Whitfield's in. So Fry was cooking in that first quarter, and we've barely seen him here in the second quarter.
Yeah, he went out a couple minutes into the second quarter after a foul.
And
maybe he's
3.
Trying to protect him, but
that was DiCapua
with a 3-pointer there.
How many points is he up to now?
He's up to 12 points. So we're looking at 2 guys, Kwiatkowski and DiCapua, who are leading the charge here for Allegany Limestone.
And most of those have come from downtown.
Yep, they have a handful of three-pointers, and they're getting them to fall right now. Fredonia did early.
Game clock and shot clock are dead even. 12 seconds left.
Fredonia setting up for that last shot of the half, it looks.
White puts up a tough shot.
Contested shot
it.
There.
DiCapua.
It looks like he wanted to chuck that one up from half court, but he wasn't sure if he could quite get that off.
So with that, the Allegheny Limestone Gators take a commanding 36-24 lead into the half. Something that we haven't seen this Fredonia team, we haven't seen that happen to them a lot. Like we said, they've won 8 out of their last 9. Usually they're the team that's in control, so we'll see how they respond coming out of this halftime break. We're going to take a 5-minute break of our own, compile our stats, and we'll be back in about 5 minutes and get you ready for the start of the second half.
Got any more? Anyone have any more balls? I'll take that as a no. All right. All right, 50-50. Here we go, 50-50. Everyone listen up. 724-9788. That's not happening. You know what? Hey. What? Oh, Graham, you won? Oh, let's give me your money, man. Yeah, so I'm not drawing another one. How about that? Everyone else, loser. I love the hate. Better luck next year. Hope everyone has a great night.
Back here in Fredonia, as it is halftime now. Once again, it is senior night here for the Hillbillies. Had the usual halftime event of throwing tiny little basketballs into a hula hoop, or trying to, because that's pretty hard.
I don't remember seeing that when I was in school. They're creating new games, I guess. An interesting spectacle.
So, looking at the first half stats here, it was pretty much all Ethan Fry for Fredonia and Anthony DiCapua and Carson Kwiatkowski for the Gators. I mean, there were a lot of other guys that chipped in, especially for the Gators. But what were the point totals here, Drew?
So, like you said, Fry for Fredonia carried the offense for Fredonia with 14 points. Hawk and Putney chipped in with three, and White had four himself. So there's not too much balance going on with Fredonia there. Fry took over in the first quarter and really had himself a good start to the game. On the other side, Allegany-Limestone has spread it out pretty much to everybody who's been on the floor. We've got everybody who's seen some action get on the board with some points. DiCapua, Kwiatkowski chipping in with 11 points each. Ramadan's got four. Truman, Giardini have three each. Frederick and Conroy have two each. And they're distributing the ball pretty well, too, with some assists going around. Jayhawk leads the way with five rebounds for Fredonia, leads all rebounders. And some distributed wealth there on the rebound side for Allegany-Limestone. DiCapua with two, Truman with two. A handful of guys at Fredonia also have two. What I think we saw, though, if we want to give a quick recap here, is Allegany-Limestone really possessed the ball. They set up their offense. They took time off the clock. A lot of times we saw them not shooting until there was less than 10 seconds on the shot clock. A couple of opportunities from some steals made some fast break points for them as well. I think that kind of tilted it in their favor early in the second quarter when it was a little bit tighter. Fredonia's moving a pretty fast-paced offense once they get into the offensive side of the court, where their bodies are constantly moving, creating opportunities for guys to get open. But the defense for Allegany-Limestone has really been pretty tough, following, not letting them get open, contested shots. It's created a little bit of frustration, I'd think, for Fredonia.
And they're right on pace defensively, because we talked about during the pregame show, they are allowing 46.5 points per game, and they only gave up 24 in that first half. So give or take a couple points, I mean, they're right on track to stay within that range. And then looking at the offensive side, I would say they're a little bit more than on pace. You know, they're averaging about 60 points per game, and right now they're on pace for 72.
That's
so
right. And
real nice first half all around for them.
I think that really plays a big part, again, talking about how long they're possessing the ball. Their defense isn't having to spend a ton of time defending, especially with the pace that Fredonia is pushing on the offensive side. 46.5 points against for Allegany-Limestone. Like we said, they're looking at an average at the halftime at about 48. Fredonia's going to need to kick it up a notch here with their offense. They're averaging 65 points a game, basically, and they're well off pace at the 24-point mark.
Yeah, I was going to say the main takeaway here for Fredonia is, you know, honestly, they played some pretty solid defense. Maybe it doesn't look like giving up 36 points. You know, they're a pretty strong defensive team themselves, so they're a little bit slightly above average in that category tonight. But they played solid defense. It's just like you said, the Gators do such a good job of possessing the ball, and they tire you out, and they just move the ball around so well that sometimes you can play great defense, but you get a zip pass down low, nice backdoor cut. There's sometimes you just can't do much about it.
Right, and we saw that late in the second half, or the first half, second quarter there, with a couple of cuts to the rim, creating opportunities for Allegheny Limestone to get some rebounds and some buckets off rebounds on the offensive side. And you're right, their possession is really just kind of opening it up for themselves, where they're not doing a ton of movement individually. They're kind of staying in their spots, moving the ball to where they need to go, and creating these backdoor cuts every once in a while, and maybe a guy going missing in the defense.
And Fredonia's going to have to do that here in the second half, because, like we were saying, 24 points in the first half is not going to cut it. And if they double that, 48 points is not going to cut it either. So they're going to have to do something to find some more offense here, whether the Gators are playing strong defense or not. So here we go. Jayhawk hands it off to Ethan Fry here. Mike Hahn will try a three right away. No good. Rebounded by Giardini. Gators with a 12-point lead here to start the second half.
I think it goes without saying Fredonia's going to need to look for a quick start to this third quarter. I know that's what they drew up there with a quick three-point attempt. Didn't fall for them, but not to be discouraged, they can keep at it.
Contested three is good. DeCapua with 14 points now. Ties Ethan Fry for a game high. And Fry was right in his face too, but he just has a sweet stroke. Now Fry comes back the other way. No good there, rebounded by DeCapua.
Showing why he's averaging that 17 and a half.
Puts up the floater, does not put it in. Rebounded by Hahn. Fry looks to push here.
Fry spent a lot of time on the bench in the second quarter here. He should be fresh to start. I wonder if that was part of the plan that Fredonia had for him.
Well, he puts up the three here. That one is short and hits the top of the backboard, so automatic turnover.
I think it's clear in the early goings here that Fredonia's going to look for some deep shots, try to get maximum points on their possessions here. They're going to need to have some of these three-pointers fall, though, obviously, if they want to get back in this. As a 15-point deficit, it's not going to be easy to climb out of.
Fredonia playing their 2-3 zone, and DeCapua finds a hole but can't get that one to drop. Ball goes out of bounds and going to Fredonia.
Now, the referee had an interesting look at that play there. I had a much better look, and he got the call right, as Allegheny Limestone's hand reached in there and knocked that ball out. Looking for a rebound opportunity there was Hahn.
Fry will drive in now. He stops. Now gives it to Hahn. Back to Fry. Fry drives in. Spins around. Puts up another tough shot. And that one is good. Ethan Fry with his first couple points in the second half.
He is throwing his offense tonight. That's a really nice strong drive to the rim. Contested shot goes down for him. Hawk drags down a rebound, another one for him.
Actually, that was White.
Correction.
Who puts up the three here. No good. Fredonia's still pretty cold here.
They're looking for those points. Maybe they need to establish themselves a little bit better here, try to take a page out of Allegheny Limestone's book. Possess the ball, move it around, take 2 points if you have to. It counts all the same.
Kickball here, so it'll be staying here with the Gators. But yeah, I agree. I mean, we haven't even really seen Jayhawk do anything in the paint. His three points came from a three-pointer, and that's something that we're not used to seeing from him. So I think they just need to work the ball down low a little bit more, try to get Hawk involved, see what Davion White can do. Another nice backdoor cut, and Giardini finishes.
That's five on the night for him. Ramadan with a nice pass in.
15-point lead now. The ref said something after that. I wasn't sure what the call was. There wasn't a foul or anything. Something happened at the end of the play, though. Jim is still pretty quiet here in Fredonia. Going to need a couple of big buckets here to get them back into it. Here's Hawk in the paint. Over to White. Strong take, but he will get rewarded with a trip to the charity stripe.
That was a good drive to the rim, and just as you said it, working the ball inside, getting Hawk involved down low. They go to it, create an opportunity. I think he drew in a couple defenders there, especially with looking. You know, they took their eyes off of the guys they're covering. Create an opportunity for White to take a drive to the rim. Just couldn't quite get it to fall, but does get the foul.
First free throw is good. You know, I must say, for as much as I've been saying that the gym is quiet, we have some pretty nice headsets here, and that blocks out a lot of noise. So maybe it's a little bit louder than I've been giving them credit for, but still, 41-28 now after he makes those free throws. They need a couple of big stops here and a couple of big possessions on offense to really get this crowd back into it.
Defense active early on the defensive side for Fredonia here.
However, but Carson Kwiatkowski just keeps burying him.
Keeps going as he adds to his totals.
How many is that for him now?
He's up to 14 himself.
Fredonia misses a shot on the other end. This is Ramadan with Fry all over him. Turnaround jumper from the Gators, no good. Offensive rebound, also no good. That first shot was off the hand of Michael Frederick, junior point guard. Fry in the corner, drives baseline, gets that one poked away. Passes it into Davion White, scoop layup off the mark. Rebounded by Ramadan.
It looks like they isolated two players down low for that offensive possession there.
And another three. Carson Kwiatkowski, the sophomore, doing his damage here. 47-28.
The early goings here of the second half have been Kwiatkowski and DeCapua for Allegany-Limestone leading the way.
Now Fryer will try a three, and that one is clean. And Fredonia needed that in the worst way.
That's a big bucket there.
They're going to need a few more of those, so we'll take a break as we have a timeout called on the floor. Back with you in 1 minute here on Public Access. Back here with a little over 3.5 minutes to go in the third quarter. As the Gators have the ball here, another nice backdoor cut. DeCapo can't finish, rebounded by Ethan Fry. Fry looks to push. Hillbillies have some numbers. White out to Hawk. He'll try another three, and that one's good. 2 for 2 from behind the stripe for Jay Hawk. 47-34.
2 3-pointers for Hawk. Interesting to see out of the big man.
Ramadan with Hawk on him. Tries to go behind the back. Gets a little tripped up there. Shot was no good, but tracked down by Truman. Now back out. Kwiatkowski off the mark there. A little bit short. Another offensive rebound. This is Frederick. Now to Capo. I thought about that three. Out to Ramadan. 25 on the shot clock, so no need to rush.
Kind of a crazed offensive possession here for Allegheny Limestone. Ball's kind of going all over the place.
Turnaround shot from the left block is good from Frederick.
4 points on the night for Frederick.
Frederick is one of those guys we mentioned during the pregame, averaging a little over 7 a game, so real balanced scoring attack here for the Gators.
Chipping in with 2 points here and there is going to get you there.
Ethan Fry got fouled shooting a three, so he'll be going to the stripe for 3 free throws.
Looking to add to his totals for the night. Fredonia's going to need these 3 points here. Try to chip away against this 15-point lead.
First one is short. Second one is too long.
0 for 2 to start that. See if he can get this third one to fall.
And he was money from the line the other night. I want to say he was 11 and 12. I could have my numbers wrong, but.
That's impressive.
Yeah, he was making them when they mattered. He makes this one here. So 49 to 35, still a lot of time left here, but they have to get a stop here on defense.
And that's the thing, Fredonia does have time. We've seen them be able to get some bursts of points here and there. And if they can play some stout defense here, they really need to get some possession, some defensive possessions that are good like that, where you can get a rebound, go down, and turn that into some points.
Fry out to Hawk. He'll try another three.
Why not?
Three for three for Jay Hawk from downtown. I believe those are all of his points tonight.
He has 9 points on 3 three-pointers. I think he's, was he 3 for 3 on the night, yeah, with 3-pointers? I could say we weren't expecting that out of him for a performance tonight. Nice steal.
Ethan Fry strips to Capo, comes back coast to coast. He gets stripped himself. And now Ramadan will slow it down. Fry looks for another steal.
He's got some aggressive defense going here. Played a little aggressively going down with that fast break after the steal.
Conroy uses a screen. Now into the corner with Ramadan, down low, Truman. And that bank shot is good. The third leading scorer for the Gators, Gavin Truman, gets it back to a 13-point game.
That was really nice individual work by Truman there. He had a one-on-one matchup, possessing the ball, keeping it away from any opportunity to steal it.
Baseline jumper is money from Mike Hahn.
Hahn getting on the board for the first time tonight.
40 seconds left here in the third quarter, 11-point game.
And just like that, we talked about a 15-point lead. A couple of defensive possessions were needed. They cut it to 11-13 again.
That was Truman. 25 seconds left, shot clock is turned off. Fredonia can hold for one if they choose. Hawk gets open for another three. Wow. 4 for 4. Jay Hawk keeping the Hillbillies in this game, back to a 10-point game.
And just like that, Fredonia's turned the momentum into their favor.
5 seconds left now, crowd back into it. Step back three from Kwiatkowski, no good. Offensive rebound.
He had an opportunity to put that away. I think he didn't really think it was a doable shot. It didn't go down for him. But Fredonia really just pressed the last 2 minutes there, created a 5-point chip away at that 15-point lead, only down 10 with the fourth quarter looming.
Yeah. At the end of three quarters, the score is, as you can see on the scoreboard here, 53 to 43 in favor of Allegany-Limestone. And to be honest, Fredonia really didn't do anything that different in that third quarter. I mean, they got a few stops on defense, but then the Gators still found some buckets here and there. And one of the most unlikely outcomes is what is keeping them in this game right now. Jay Hawk burying 4 triples. You know, we talked about them working their offense a little bit more, trying to get the ball down low, maybe using Hawk's size to his advantage or to their advantage in the paint. But 4 triples for the 6'3 senior forward.
Right, and so we didn't expect that, and perhaps Allegany-Limestone didn't either, but he's looking really good throwing it up. It clearly is a part of his game, and they're really important big threes too, especially that late one to help chip away at this Allegany-Limestone lead. And to start the third quarter, Allegany-Limestone came out here, and they just took command, but Fredonia really countered late, getting a couple of turnovers, and those empty possessions are going to be huge for Fredonia. They're going to need to create some more of that, keeping them off the board when they get that offensive possession set up. Allegany-Limestone still looking to set up and drag time off the clock with their possessions. But if Fredonia can create a couple more turnovers here, they can get themselves right back in it.
The Gators kind of play like a football team in the sense that they're not going to just throw all over you. They're going to chew up the clock. They're going to keep the ball on the ground, give it to their running backs, right, you know. So that's the sense that I'm getting here, but not right there.
And that's the fastest possession I think we've seen these guys go after the rim. I think Giardini's the one who's going to put those 2 points up on the board for him.
Another nice backdoor cut.
Right, and so that's what they've been doing. They've been setting up, passing it around, being opportunistic when an opening is created.
Dave Van White is going to get fouled, so Fredonia will be throwing it in from under their hoop. It'll be Fry throwing it into Whitfield. Now over to Mike Hahn. Nice pass to Hawk. There was a play that I've been waiting for. Hawk can't finish, but he's going to the line. But I think that's what we need to see more from this Hillbillies team in the final 7:24 of this game.
We saw it in the third quarter, just after you had mentioned it, that they used him down low in one of those possessions that created a really nice opportunity for White to take it to the rim. They were watching him possess the ball, and just right there, he's taking it to the rim. He gets one of those free throws. Let's get the other one here. But yeah, I think that could be a good recipe for them. Possess the ball, get it down low, use the guy's size to his advantage.
2 for 2 from the charity stripe for Jayhawks. So finally, we have some points that have not been scored from behind the three-point line for Jayhawk. But hey, whatever gets it done, right?
That's right.
Gators working around here. This is Truman. Uses a screen, no foul. And DiCapo comes back, puts up a tough shot, no good. Rebounded by Whitfield. Whitfield running the show now. Gives it to Fry, top of the key. Backs down his defender, drives in. Tough shot, no good. Rebounded by DiCapo.
He dragged in two defenders there.
Now a turnover here, Fry comes up with it. 2-on-3. Jayhawk open for another three. That was his first miss. Gators with the rebound. 6.5 to go here on this Friday night in Fredonia. More nice ball movement from Allegany. And another nice backdoor cut. And one. Count it. Gavin Truman really coming alive here in the second half.
9 points on the night for him, quietly putting that together.
And I believe 7 have come in this half.
That's
correct?
Right. That is right. He had 2 coming into the second half. They've used him on a couple of those cutbacks, drives to the rim, back door. It's open. And he muscles his way to 2 points there, looking for 3.
Looking for point number 10, and he gets it to drop. Make that 58-45.
Allegany-Limestone just not quite ready to give up the double digits.
Fredonia looks a little confused here on offense. White drives in, spins around, kicks it back out to Fry. He'll drive in, and his shot is a little too strong, rebounded by Ramadan. He'll look to slow things down.
Yeah, expect a lot of this from Allegany-Limestone for the rest of this game with 5:45 remaining. They're just going to probably drag out these possessions like they did in the first half, which created some success for them anyway.
Now Giardini will drive in. No one's there for the help, and I believe they're going to get Davi White with the foul.
Interesting looking drive. I'm no critic of a ref, but I didn't see anything there.
Got him from behind, so Giardini will be at the line. What does he have for points tonight, Drew?
Giardini's got 7 so far with 2 rebounds and an assist.
So right at his season average.
A little extra muscle on that one. Not going to drop.
Again, the Gators are 14-3. They started the season 7-0. And then they dropped a game to Salamanca on January 13th. They lost to the same Hillbillies team on the 20th of January, 74-71 in overtime, as you can't get either to fall. And then they lost to Salamanca again on February 2nd.
Right.
So they've won 5 out of their last 6, and they're playing pretty sharp here tonight.
Yeah, it's 5 out of the last 6 since that loss to Fredonia. Coming in here looking for a little revenge, I'm sure. Playing like it.
Hawks waiting for someone to make a cut. White does, but can't connect with them there.
One of the Gators got their hand in between the two players, knocked the ball out of bounds.
Well, the Gators are averaging 46 points allowed, so Fredonia is pretty much right there. So we'll see if they can get anything else going here. I would assume they're going to score more than 1 point over the final 5 minutes, but the Gators...
Safe assumption.
Gators have been playing some strong defense here.
Hawk down low there.
Too strong. Another rebound for Truman.
Four on the night for him.
Allegany works it around. Down low to Frederick. Can't get it to fall there.
Whitfield gets the rebound there. Interesting possession there. I know I've mentioned it multiple times so far, these drawn out possessions by Allegheny Limestone on the offensive side. They kind of moved it quickly there, got a shot early instead of late like they've been doing in the first half.
Keegan Whitfield gets fouled on the other end, so that'll be on the floor. Fry will be inbounding it. Looks like they're gonna get Giardini with that foul. It'll be his second, the team's fifth. White gets the inbound pass. That one was too strong, a little bit too much mustard there. 13-point lead, 4.5 to go. Clock's not running. I don't know if anyone's noticed that.
Fans noticed. Referees
clock
did not.
Is still not running. And there we go, okay. Well, we got extra 30 seconds of this game here. Hahn gets that one stripped from behind.
A little confusion here for everybody.
Okay, so now Gators will reset it here. The clock is running, shot clock is running. We're all good. Ramadan's wide open, and he makes that layup.
Truman with a great pass down low. 6 points for Ramadan.
And that'll force Nick Bertrando to call a timeout, as he does not like what he sees here. The Hillbillies are down by 15 with 4 minutes to go. Really, there should probably be about 3 minutes and 40 seconds, but
I'd say three and a half minutes here. We had a scorekeeper's gaffe.
We'll keep it with you here during this timeout and just talk about what has transpired here in the second half and what to expect moving forward. So it's pretty much been more of the same here. Do you remember what the score was at halftime? I failed to write that down on my sheet. It was 20-17.
36-24.
That's
was
right, okay.
The score. So what happened here is Allegany Limestone came out and they were flying. They've been spreading the ball around a little bit more than they did in the first half. DeCapua and Kwiatkowski led the way in the first half. We've seen Truman and Giardini step up this half, chipping in with a handful of points each. DeCapua, Kwiatkowski leaving off pretty much, or coming back where they left off. For Fredonia, Hawk has stayed hot with the three-pointers. He's got 14 points on the night. Fry came back in, leaving 14 points on the board in the first half. He's chipped in with six here in the second half. But we're seeing a little bit of all the same here. Allegany's possessing the ball really well, opportunistic on the defensive side, gathering in those the defensive rebounds, a couple on the offensive side. We've seen a little bit of confusion in the last minute or so with some turnovers and some fast breaks. But it's been kind of the same that the second quarter had us going with possessions from the Gators.
Well, the score was 53-43 at the end of three. So the Hillbillies have only scored 2 points so far this quarter.
They're going to need a little bit more than that in this last 4 minutes. Down 15. That's a tall task, but
Whitfield gets open down low and a strong take there. Big bucket there for the senior.
That's the first one for him tonight. That's the first 2 points as he gets on the score sheet.
Whitfield's not much of a scorer, but he knows his role and he plays it pretty well.
Played really good defense on DeCapua right there. Turnovers created. Fredonia's going to transition now.
Fry crosses up his defender, and we're going to have a foul on the floor. Not sure exactly who is going to get called on that one. Oh, so that'll go on Michael Frederick. That'll be his fourth. So a little bit of foul trouble there for the Gators. Yeah. Hahn tries a three. Banks are not open at this time.
Stays in the game, though, as Ramadan brings down that rebound.
Ramadan doesn't have too many points tonight, but He knows his role as well. Shot is no good, rebounded by Fry. 3 minutes to go here. Hibbley's down 13. Pull-up jumper for Fry is good.
Nice shot choice. Quick possession. Didn't waste any time on the shot clock. Get down, get 2 points. Go play some defense.
Well, Fredonia needs to stop here. You know, there's still time left in this game, but you can't keep trading buckets.
No, that's absolutely right. And this is going to be that slow dragging out of the clock here. We'll probably start to see them take some fouls.
DiCapua drives in, and he's going to draw a foul. He's been relatively quiet here, but he's still come up with the big plays when he's had to.
He chipped in 6 points in the third quarter, but he stopped scoring probably 8 minutes ago. His presence is still felt, though. The eyes are all on him.
So the Gators will be inbounding it here from underneath their hoop. DiCapo gets open in the corner. Fresh 35 now. So, yeah, you know, I mentioned how you can't be trading buckets, especially with a team like the Gators who, like you've been saying all night, they will just chew up that clock.
Mm-hmm. And they're doing it again here as we see them approaching 15 seconds now on the shot clock. They're in no hurry to get that ball to the rim. And if Fredonia's not going to follow them to stop the clock, I think Allegany-Limestone's really content with that.
Strong take there from DiCapo, but he can't get it to drop. Jayhawk the other way with a nice find from Ethan Fry. Gets us back to a single-digit game.
16 points on the night for Hawk. Really nice pass below the rim there for Fry.
What's Fry at now?
22.
So he has 22, Hawk was 16. So 38 out of the 51 Fredonia points tonight.
Two-man band.
Pretty much.
Whitfield, Hahn, White, they've gotten involved. Got themselves on the board. Putney had a three-pointer in the first half as well. Haven't seen much of him here in the second half.
Hahn with just 2 points. White with six. Whitfield two. And then Putney with that three-pointer. So, yeah, it's pretty much been Ethan Fry and Jay Hawk tonight, the two seniors, or two of the seniors on this team. So 60-51 is the score. Minute 52 remaining in this game. Now, here's a question. Normally, teams, based on the score, you know, depending on what the score is, usually wait until about a minute to start the foul game, give or take. But with a team like the Gators, do you start that process a little bit sooner?
You know, that's a tough question. It's a three-possession game if you break it down by how many points they can score on each possession.
They missed Giardini wide open right there. So
and I think Allegheny's going to look to just chew this clock up like they've been doing. Nothing's going to change for them. It seems like Fredonia's going to be content with letting them move the ball around for this possession anyway.
I think you play straight up here. Now they're going to foul. You can't be doing that now.
That seems right. Interesting foul call there as he calls.
So they wasted 25 seconds right there. I was going to say play it straight up. Right. Hopefully you get a stop. And then hopefully you can score the other way, and then you start the foul game. But now you get a fresh 35. I think they're going to have to start fouling. Yep.
Yeah. And that's what this is going to be for the next minute and a half, which might end up taking 10 minutes based on how many fouls that they're going to go after. They're not going to the line yet. They haven't quite reached that point. But we'll get there soon.
Ethan Fry with the foul. That'll be Fredonia's sixth foul. So the Gators are still going to be inbounding it here before they have to start shooting free throws. So that's another reason why you want to start the foul process a little bit earlier. This is DiCapua with Fry on him. Fry with three fouls. So
and I think they want to avoid having him foul at this point.
He can get one more, but then he's going to have to be careful.
Right.
Fredonia playing this straight up, though. And they leave Kwiatkowski wide open under the hoop for an easy two. That might have been the dagger.
19
under a minute to go.
Kwiatkowski.
And they're going to get Fry for a push-off. That'll be his fourth.
Unfortunate for them.
So 62-51. 54.6 seconds remaining. No need to hurry here for the Gators, but Fredonia has to foul. And they do right there.
White will be charged with that one. Well, we'll see what happens here with these free throws. If he misses, Fredonia gets a quick rebound and a possession. You know, we'd assume that they're going to be chucking up some three-pointers. One of those falls as this rebound goes to Fry. Gonna have to throw up a three-pointer.
Step back three.
You got it.
Count it. Ethan Fry gets fouled, so count the three-pointer, and he'll be going to the line, trying to make it a four-point play. So that was best-case scenario.
Absolutely.
For Fredonia. They get this to an eight-point game, possibly a seven-point game. There's still time left. We don't have the stats on the Gators' free throw success rate this season, but, you know, they've been a little bit spotty tonight from the charity stripe. So from here on out, you just got to hope that they miss their free throws, and then you can make your shots on the other end.
Right, and that was exactly what they were looking for. A rebound off the free throw. Less than 10 seconds drained off the clock. Get a three-pointer up. He makes it. Gets an and one. They're going to be looking to quickly foul after this, too.
And that foul was on number 20, Michael Frederick. So he just fouled out with five fouls. And Fry makes it. Give him 26 tonight, correct?
That is correct.
And we're going to have a timeout called here. We'll just keep it with you here.
27 for Fry.
27, okay. I'm not sure what his season high is, but either way, he's
27 points is a heck of a game.
Yeah. And we mentioned how he's averaging, coming into tonight, 14.4. So
right.
He essentially doubled that, yeah.
Yep. Yeah, so Fredonia's got to get this defensive possession. Is going to have to be following. Look to get somebody to the line, gather a rebound, and do exactly what they just did. Run down, throw up a three. There's only 32 seconds left. It's only a seven-point game, though. So if they are able to chip away, it kind of changes the game plan for on the defensive side. If they are able to get a quick turnover here, throw 3 points on the board, you got a four-point game, then it just becomes a free throw foul game.
I was going to say, so let's say they can either force a turnover, or if they can't get the turnover and they foul and the Gators miss two free throws, and then they come back and have something like that what just happened, where they make a three on the other end.
Right.
Like you said, we could be looking at a four-point game here in a matter of right. 5 to 10, well, maybe not five, but I would say about 10 seconds. So
game clock seconds, absolutely. And once these guys get that possession back, you know, just moving quickly and getting it up there, they want to get a quick foul here. That's one thing they need to do on the defensive side, and they do get it 4 seconds off the clock there.
So I believe this will be a 1-1. Fry and Putney will come back in, so two of the shooters, Whitfield and Tabone, come out.
Putney with a three-pointer on the night early.
Putney just a sophomore, but he's one of the shooters on this team. Did that count? I thought he was trying to get Conroy back in, and I thought I heard a whistle, and the other ref gave him the ball, and he shot it. Wait a sec, now the score says 63-62. We got something going on here. Yeah, but they got to get this straight now because we're not in a one-point game right
62
here.
62-55 is the score.
Yeah, but did they count that first free throw?
They shouldn't have.
I don't think they did because that was a 1-1 and they just
right.
redid it, correct?
Right. 55-62. Referee at the scoring table trying to figure this mess out.
So 63-55, 28.4 seconds left. Is this the front end of the 1-1 or they counted that? Okay, so he went 2 for 2. So 64 okay. to 55, gonna have to get a quick three. Stop and pop right here. Ethan Fry does that. Can't get it to go in though. And I think that'll do it. Gonna have another foul here. DiCapua will be going to the line.
A big rebound by DiCapua there.
So now it just seems like it's going to be too little too late.
Nice.
Assuming
lead.
He makes those free throws, you're down double digits with under 20 to go. So even with the extra 20, 25 seconds of clock that Fredonia right. was given tonight. Just That's not right. enough time for them. No, and some of the fans are starting to head towards the exits.
They put up a good fight there, down 15 points, not giving up, getting it down to a 7-point game. Really good effort by Fredonia there to try to push for a strong finish.
We'll have Whitfield, Tabone, and Mike Riddle coming back in for Fredonia for the final 19 seconds here. DeCapua makes both free throws, so 66-55.
Got 16 points for DeCapua on the night.
Hawk drives in, and his layup is good. Probably the final points for Fredonia tonight. Make that the final points for the game as the Gators will just dribble this out. And that'll do it as Allegheny improves to 15-3 on the season. Fredonia drops to 13-6. We're going to take a one-minute timeout and just compile our stats, make sure we got everything right here. And we'll be back in about 60 seconds and give you a quick post-game wrap-up. With you now for a little post-game wrap-up here as the Gators take this one by a final score of 66-57. Drew, it was a good game, but not as close as I thought it was going to be. I thought it was going to come down to the wire like we saw back in Allegany-Limestone about a month ago, actually less than a month ago, as that one was a 74-71 final in overtime, but the Gators were just too much for the Hillbillies tonight.
Not quite the overtime matchup that we saw 3 weeks ago. It was a close first quarter. Allegany-Limestone really just possessed the ball so well, eating a lot of clock. Their big scorers on the night is Kwiatkowski with 19 and DeCapua with 16. Those two guys really dominated when it came to possessing the ball, and they got some good rebounds too. Fry for Fredonia had 26 points, and Hawk had 18 as the two seniors there really tried to will their team to a victory. A hard-fought game by Fredonia, in all due respect to them. Down by 15 points, they didn't give up. Fought back to get it to a 7-point deficit late in the fourth quarter, but obviously just a little too much of a deficit to overcome overall.
Yeah, so taking a look at it quarter by quarter, it was pretty close in the opening quarter. The crowd was into it. Senior night here in Fredonia, the Gators jumped out to a 20-17 lead, and then they outscored the Hillbillies 16-7 in the second quarter, giving them a 36-24 halftime lead. And then they added to that lead in the third quarter, going up 53-43. And that was all they needed, essentially, as they got 13 more points in the fourth quarter. Fredonia with 14, but again, it was just too little too late with the final score coming at 66-57. And I think the main takeaway here for Fredonia is that they weren't far off tonight. It's just they needed more help behind Fry and Hawk. And, you know, we talked about the balanced scoring attack for the Hillbillies. We've talked about it all season. And Davion White didn't do too much tonight. And Mike Hahn, he only had 2 points. So, obviously, you're going to need those guys to step up. And for the regular season, it's good to have four guys who can score. But this was kind of like a playoff atmosphere. This is a playoff game where the Gators are going to be really tough down the road in February and then into March. So I think this showed me, at least, and I'm sure the Fredonia Hillbillies, that they're going to need more guys to step up down the season. Even if all four guys are clicking, they're going to have to find someone else who can be a spark off the bench.
That's right. You got to have that balance, and Fredonia's had that throughout the season. They're going to need to find that as they have a quick turnaround. I believe they play Monday night. But it's just one game. Take your lumps, move on, try to do better. I want to give a quick shout-out to our staff, Cody Decker, Andrew Hunter, Jackson Hickey, Ryan Doltz, Mark Mackey, and, of course, Chip. Thank you for all the work you've done behind the scenes for us here tonight. Couldn't do it without you.
And thank you for joining me, Drew. Again,
wonderful.
This is our first time calling a game together, so I think it went pretty well.
Absolutely. Great
time
here.
Hope we get to do some more games together again. Not sure exactly what the schedule is looking like next week because it's the last week of the regular season. So, like we said, Fredonia, they're going to be done after Monday night. Again, they dropped to 13-6 tonight. So they will be looking to finish the regular season 14-6 in Olean, and then it's playoff time for them. I do know that Dunkirk has some games next week. I'll be back with WDE calling those games. And like I said, it'll be time for March Madness a little bit early, a week early. I guess February Madness for the last week of February, is we're going to have a lot of high school basketball playoff action coming up for you.
Fun times.
Between all the different networks around here. So, again, Fredonia drops this one, as you can see on the score right there, 66-57 to fall to 13-6. Gators improve to 15-3. So, for Kevin Syracuse and Drew Yelich, you've been watching Fredonia High School basketball on Public Access. Have a good rest of your night and weekend.